So Fishman with the ball back outside to York. Laughlin has not taken a shot as yet. York fakes. He starts partway down now in the corner to Norton. Norton looks inside, but all he sees is trees. Now back outside to York, and they want to pull it out a little bit more. Well, Bob, you know, in the 1950 season, Stearns played John Baps. It was quite a contest for the Eastern Maine final.
Now we're going to hold it. There comes Manaman.
Well, Baps could win 2-0. Bounce in the middle to Curtis, now to Fishman. Fishman starts to move with it, back outside to York. York turns, now to Norton. Norton can't get the baseline because Rassie's there. Back outside to York. Fishman was all alone. Now they see him. I don't think they want to take the first shot. 2-0 with 5:24 in first quarter action. It's going to be an easy game to referee, I guess. Curtis. Curtis turns to Fishman. Fishman starts to go. Fishman in the middle, but the ball over to Webster. Webster is there, and Webster picks it off.
Looking for Norton cutting to the basket, but he wasn't there.
LeBlanc now to Baxter. Baxter back to LeBlanc. Goes to Murray on the left side for John Baps, leading 2-0. Now to Baxter. Inside to Murray. Murray's going to put it up and in. 4-0.
4-0 Baps right away. Now they've come back with their own version of the 1-3-1 zone, or a big 1-2-2 zone.
Curtis in the middle of traffic. Now back outside to Jamie York. Skips a pass to Fishman. Fishman takes a shot. It's no good. Rebound by Rassi. And the little people try to come in to converge, but he holds the ball over his head, and Baps goes the other way. Right side goes to Baxter. Now to Dorian LeBlanc. Now to Baxter. Right side goes to Webster. Webster starts in the middle, stops, skips a pass in, but Curtis knocks it away.
It's quick hands by Curtis that time on the diagonal pass. First sub coming in, is that Russ Bartlett? Brian Bartlett, excuse me, Brian.
Yep. Brian, a senior, and he'll replace Curtis. Goes to LeBlanc. Baps leading 4-0, first quarter action. Outside three by Webster's no good, rebound by Fishman. Off the Rockland Tigers, and they'll come down the other way.
Is there a half-court trap?
3:52 left in the first quarter action. Norton back outside to Catalan. Now to York, Connor Fishman. Fishman loops it back outside to York. This will be the game that Jamie can throw up his threes. Catalan down the middle. Baps converges. Now to Battle. Battle's going to take a pop. No good. Rebound up and lost. And picked up by Battle. He puts it in.
Good rebound that time by Brian Bartlett. Kept things alive in Rockland. Went up, got the rebound strong, went back up and was fouled by Murray, Peter Murray. I'm going to see that. Here it is right here. They keep it alive. Rassi comes down with it, and there's the block out by Fishman.
Fishman got the ball.
And here comes Bartlett with a loose ball, fouled by Murray from behind.
And it's 4-3. I think they've got Bartlett in there on the foul line because it is open, and he put up a right-hander, and then with the rebound action, he was able to convert a deuce and then a single, so it's 4-3. Dorian LeBlanc loops it into Rassi. Goodbye. Rassi puts it in.
Acknowledges the pass from LeBlanc, but like I say, they got to put some pressure on the ball. They want to keep Rassi away from those little layups.
York now to Bartlett. Bartlett turns, goes to Norton. Norton's going to go. He's waited long enough. Cleans out two. I don't know which one he got, but he took two of them like a bowling ball when he went through.
Right. Foul on Norton. He took down LeBlanc and got a piece of Rassi.
Only one team foul on both sides. York goes to the sidelines, and coming in is Ryan Baker. Baker, number 11, is outside. Looks like they've got a what, a 1-2-2?
1-3-1.
1-3-1 as they move, trying to hold Rassi down. Pass into Murray. Murray on the other side, he puts it in.
Can't stay in this too long, I don't think. I think he's got to get out of this zone or get a little bit more pressure on the ball or be a little bit more active.
8-3 the score now, 2:27. Just about all layups by John Bass. Goes to Bartlett. Now to Catalan. Catalan back outside to Baker. Baker right side to Naughton. Naughton skips it outside to Baker and he's called for foul.
You notice where Rockland is starting their offense from the top of the key to half court, whereas John Babs is starting their offense right around the foul line. Quite a difference in the offensive sets by both teams, and I think it's caused by Babs's defense, obviously.
8-3 to score. Nice interception by Catalan. Ball was deflected and he picked it off. 8-3 with 1:59 left. As Baker comes down with it to Catalan. Catalan's going to go with it. Woo! He's not going to go anymore. Back to Naughton. Naughton skips it across to Bartlett. Bartlett halfway down. Now in the middle goes to Fishman. Fishman's LeBlanc comes up with it. Number two in a row by Rockland, just trying to get into an offensive flow.
8-3, the score, 1:35 left. York will check back in for Rockland momentarily. Webster on the right side, now out to Baxter. Baxter back to Webster. Now it comes back to Baxter as he looks over to Dorian Gray. Dorian Gray is up. Dorian LeBlanc. 1:16 left. They'll probably play for the last shot, would you say?
I don't know. They'll look for an opening.
LeBlanc started to go in, and they're going to call a foul. And LeBlanc,
right? A push off, I think, by LeBlanc on the drive. Simpson, wait a minute.
The most confused people in the auditorium. 1:09 left. So, it's on. They get, yeah,
here
22.
It is right
okay.
Here. There's a push away right there with a right hand on Dorian LeBlanc.
1:05 left. Catalan goes to Naughton, middle to Fishman. Fishman hooks the pass inside to Battle. He puts it up. It's no good. They can't afford to miss those. Tough shot. Probably heard some steps. Baxter comes back with it. 49 seconds left. LeBlanc now to Baxter. All right, he's going back outside. They're going to wait and let the clock go down. So at the end of one, it looks like John Babs is going to be ahead 8-3. 30 seconds left now as they're going to hold the ball. Good time to go to the refrigerator. Do you want to?
Rockland fans getting a little impatient behind us. Boring. We'll start hearing that very soon.
So what happened to the rule that would force the play?
That rule has been discontinued as far as high school basketball.
So they could stay in there for 8 minutes then if the other team doesn't do anything.
That's correct.
LeBlanc, 3 seconds, takes the shot. It's no good. Rebounded by Murray at the buzzer. And we've got a 10-3 game. John Babs will be back with second quarter action right after this.
Okay, 10-3 at the end of the first period here at the auditorium. John Babs in the lead. Out on the floor very quickly. The Crusaders and Chris Elkington speaking to his team. He's got to get some offensive flow. John Babs's zone has been extended to half court, and Rockland having all kinds of problems. They got to come into the middle, down the wings to create an advantage going to the basket.
Checking in will be Chris Seavey for the Rockland Tigers. Number 25, Naughton still in there, York, Fishman, and Battler. Battler comes to the foul line, turns, goes to Fishman. York, Webster's on him, Webster's 6'8". Skips a pass to Naughton, Naughton's gonna go in, Naughton puts it up, and no good. Rebound tipped around, and Battler's gonna be fouling from behind. So it's just, when you do get in there, you still got to put it up as you normally would, because you can't be afraid what Rassi's going to do, although he did it.
Here's the intimidation factor right here. Here comes Naughton with the ball. He's going to change the shot right there. Rassi changes his shot. And here's the rebounding foul by Bartlett.
That's only the first on Bartlett. Two on both teams now for the team fouls. They have to commit 7 before the 1-on-1. We're in the second quarter right now. Rassi, good foul by Naughton because it prevented the basket.
Right, little loop pass inside. Rassi set up on the blocks. A little bit different set coming into their offense from the corner instead of the top on diagonals. They're going with a loop pass.
LeBlanc outside, loops it into Webster. Webster at the baseline right side. Now goes to LeBlanc, 10-3 to score. Long pass goes to Baxter. Now to Murray through his hands, but LeBlanc is there. There's Rassi. No one's going to stop him, and he puts it in.
Turns around and lays it in. Here comes the trap. Half court. Camera picks it up very nicely.
12-3 the score. Fishman now to York. Now to Norton. Norton's probably the most impatient of the five out there now. He wants to go to the hole. He'll take Mr. Rassi on, but Rassi's got about a yard on him. Pass goes to Bartlett, right side to Fishman. Fishman comes that way out now, loops a pass to Norton. Norton stops with it. Rassi comes out to challenge. Now to Fishman. Fishman's going to move up, and he gets fouled.
Now by Webster. Pretty good ball movement that time by Rockland. They showed a little bit of patience, and I think what they've got here comes Fishman in your picture. There's Webster, 54, and there's the foul. One of the things they got to do is when they get a good outside shot, they've got to take it.
York with the ball now. York moves to the left side, looking for help, skips it across to Fishman. Fishman starts to move, gets everybody moving with him. Now to Norton. Norton takes the baseline, back out York. York's got a good three high out there, and finally, Jamie York, so that's good ball movement, got it back outside, and bang.
Exactly, they took it to the baseline, which the zone collapsed, and then York was able to hit the outside shot.
12-6 the score, second quarter action, 5:55. Hope you're enjoying our telecast on Maine Public Television. Baxter goes to LeBlanc, right side to inside. Now it goes to Rassi. Rassi's going to put it up, and he gets fouled while he's putting it up.
Right, foul on York, I believe. Basket's good. Nice drop step move by Ken Rassi. And here in the second quarter, another pass coming in. Here it is. There it is right there. Nice strong move, and coming into the picture is York.
All right, Jamie.
No way, Jamie. I'm sorry, young man. You're not going to get a piece of that one.
Looked like TJ Sprague kind of come in. 14-6 the score. Rassi's up and good. So Rassi hasn't committed any fouls, and you know, the ball goes in there. He holds it up, and what are you going to do?
Having himself a very, very strong game, and he's very, very intense in this game. Calling out the defenses. Hands up, he's saying. Here's the zone again. Here's the trap right at half court.
Fishman with the ball. Catiline now goes to Norton. Norton starts. Nice move inside. Goes to Seavey. Puts it up and in.
Good move. Excellent play by Norton. Seavey made the cut to the same side of the ball and was able to reverse and go back for the layup.
15-8 the score. LeBlanc now. Dorian to the left side. Goes to Baxter. Back at the top to Webster to the right. Webster now goes to Baxter. Baxter with a baseline shot, and he hits it.
A double team that time on Rassi, front and rear, and Baxter ended up with an open jump shot.
17-8, Baps leading. Goes to Norton. Norton fakes, starts to move down, going to go right up the middle, and he draws a foul on Webster.
Michael is bound to determine he's going to get a shot off in there against the trees, and that time he took it right to Webster. Here comes a left-handed dribble into the lane. Here comes Webster. And there's the foul.
17-8 the score. Second quarter action with 4:52 remaining. Bob Simulant looks on as Webster's picked up his second personal foul. Norton's foul shot. That's one thing they got to do is make fouls. They're going to stay in this one.
They've got to make every shot right. That they have a great chance of making. Well, a good percentage shot. And this is one of the better ones right here. 15.
This is your open shot. And he makes one of two as York is ready to check back in. Bartlett will go to the sideline for Rockland. No, it's going to be Norton. So Norton will go out. 14 fouls on both sides of the ledger now for Rockland and for John Baps. As LeBlanc brings down to the left side on the dribble. Way outside to Baxter. Goes to LeBlanc. In a game like this where Simulant has developed the slow, deliberate style, and one of his students is Chris Elkington, and you can imagine what we're up against. The shot is all glass by Baxter, but he gets it back, so a lucky break for John Babs. And he followed his shot. LeBlanc's going to go in, puts it up, partially deflected, and they're going to call a foul on Rassi.
Right over the top, Rassi against Bartlett on the rebounding action. LeBlanc had a pretty good opportunity at a layup that time. Here he comes, right here, goes up, just shot, and is Bartlett, and here comes Rassi over the top for the foul. So 17-9, Rockland hanging around, hanging in there. Much better flow and motion and movement
on their offense in this, the second period versus the first period. Got a little basketball pitch here. We know everybody in Eastern Maine has been watching us, correct?
I hope so.
I assume they like us.
Our wives have, let's put it that way.
Right, I assume they like us, and if you do, please send us a message saying that you do. Send it to Maine Public Television, 1450 Lisbon Street, Lewiston, Maine, 04240.
Maine Public Television, as we've been here for a while.
And as we say in Bottles and James, we thank you for your support.
17-9 the score. If you're looking for a Washington County shootout, that won't be until later. We'll have a Roostick and Washington County shootout tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening. But for the time being, we'll have a cat and mouse game with 17-9 the score. Grassi only committed his first personal foul, so he is in no danger here in the second quarter. 4:06, Norton starts to move Cataline. A little bit too strong, and goes out of bounds.
A little bit out of control. He was falling that time and lost control of the ball.
As I say, the most impatient player on the floor right now is number 13 for Rockland, Mike Norton. He wants to get in there. But they've got to be patient, because once you get in there, you're in trouble. Baxter. Now to LeBlanc, inside to Rassi. And that's going away by Seavey.
Nice steal by Seavey. Right over Rassi and took it right out of his hand.
York with the ball. A three will wake everybody up here for Rockland. Outside to Cataline, right side to Bartlett. Bartlett holds now, starts to dribble. Now he gives to York. York's at the foul line. Now he starts to go out in the middle. Webster comes out with him. Rockland trailing 17-9. Bartlett, nice pass to York. He gives to Cataline. Cataline doesn't bother with a shot. Now it's Norton. Norton will take it if he gets in close. He comes out to York. 17-9 with 3:08 left in this first half of action. Norton fakes, turns around, back outside to Cataline. Now to Bartlett of Rockland. Back outside to Cataline. To the left goes to York. Jamie starts to drive, bounce in the middle, but right from the hands of Mr. Baxter.
Playing a little sagging man-to-man now, a little soft man-to-man is John Babson. Inviting the drive, and that time they turned it over.
Loop pass to Murray. Murray's inside and hammered by Norton.
Baxter on a nice loop diagonal pass to Peter Murray. Peter Murray's had a strong first half for John Babs. There we are. There's Murray right there underneath. And the arm was grabbed by Norton, and he's got three fouls. Going to the bench.
And Fishman comes back in for Rockland. Now Ryan Baker will check in, and York will check out. I think that's the hardest part of this offense for either side, that you just can't expect to grab it up in one big clump. And Norton has got his afterburners on, and he wants to get in there. He's in the flow of it, but once he gets inside, he tries to make shots up, and when you start making them up, you're not going to get baskets.
A little bit out of control. He's got to come under control and be disciplined.
Foul shot missed by Murray. 18-9 is the splits two. 2:36 remaining. Baker loses control, now looks for help, goes to Seavey. Three subs in there now, Bartlett, Seavey, and Baker. Cataline's a starter along with Fishman. Now to Bartlett, nice pass, but a little travel by Bartlett.
Right, and Laux came in for, Norman Laux, number 12 for Babs, came in for Webster, number 54, so that's a change for John Babs.
18-9 the score. LeBlanc down with it, now to Baxter, right side to Laux. Back to Baxter. Looks inside. Now to the corner again. As they move the ball around, 18-9 the score. 2:02 left in the first half of action. Low scoring game. And we're not responsible for that. Laux.
Lane catch up front. Baxter in the blank.
Baxter now into Rassi. Rassi turns and his offensive foul. He took Bartlett right out of the picture.
Nice play by Bartlett. Rassi leaned in, and when he did, when Bartlett felt the pressure, he just went down, and the foul was on Rassi. That's his second. Rassi's coming out. Webster's coming in. I'm sorry. Thought Rassi was going out, but Murray's going out.
And York checks back in for Rockland. 1:45 left.
Well, I think if you're Chris Elkins, then you got to be pleased.
Oh, he's not. Oh, no. I'm sure he feels very good about this, especially if he can get it a hoop right here.
In the middle of Adlett. Adlett turns back outside to Baker, right side to Fishman. Man to man now. Fishman's going to go. Has it rejected by Rassi, but you had to find out.
Right. I thought he got bumped by Baxter on the drive, but official did not see it.
18-9, 120 left in first half action. Webster on the left side now. Louts is on the right side. Rassi in the middle. Baskets inside to him. He turns and Batlett takes the ball away. Looked like he might have got an arm at the same time, but the officials did not see it. 1 minute left, 18-9. York shot, no good. Rebound goes off to Louts. And they go down the other way. 50 seconds remains in first half action.
LeBlanc one, they're going.
Inside to Rassi. Rassi back out to LeBlanc. Durian to the right side. Now they go all the way out. York comes out to challenge. Webster is in the middle. Baxter on his right. And LeBlanc's on the left side with 32 seconds left. So I think they ought to stick that rule back in. They said the game between Rockland and McDomick. McDomick, man, actually stood for 8 minutes. Chris wouldn't come out and get him, and he stood there, and the quarter was over with no shots taken, no score. McDomick about third place. Nice steal. And it goes to York. Seavey was down there, but Jamie didn't get it back to him. There comes a layup by Fishman. Good play.
Bob Simulik not very happy with that.
And Bob Simulik is going to go into the locker room all by his lonesome.
He's going in first.
Whoa.
That's not a good sign.
Tongue lashing time.
18-11. Nice.
Well, they needed that one.
Yes,
they needed
did.
That hoop at the buzzer.
That was a nice hoop and a great steal at half court. And Rockland creeps back into the game. 18-11. They've got to be pretty well pleased with that. Chris Elkington over checking on the foul situation for Rockland Tigers. They were able to solve the half court trap of Baps, and they began to penetrate the ball down the wing and get the ball along the baseline, and that opened things up for them a little bit. Chris Elkington substituting very, very freely with his players. In fact, we've seen all eight players with CV, Bartlett, and Baker coming off the bench for Rockland. So, and no foul trouble to speak of, with the exception of Norton for the Rockland Tigers.
So we're here at halftime at the Bangor Auditorium. The first game, if you just tuned in, Girls B Championship goes to Houghton Chinatown as their ninth Eastern Maine title, 57-46 over Ellsworth. John Babs led 10-3 at the end of one, and they lead by a score of 18-11 here at halftime.
Here comes the last play right here. There's York with the steal. Dorian LeBlanc goes for the steal. Here comes Fishman for the lay-in. Great execution that time on the fast break.
And Rivera.
And we are going to go to a break, and we'll be back in just a moment.
All right, thanks very much. We're here at halftime with Husson College coach Bruce McGregor. And before we get too far along, coach, I want to congratulate you. A tremendous milestone this year, reaching your 500th win. How could that happen with a man so young?
You have to be around a long time. And unfortunately, I've been there, well, not fortunately for me, I mean, it's been a labor of love, but I've been there 25 years, and I guess good things happen when you've been around so long.
You've had so much success, so many trips out to the championship tournament. What keeps it fun for you? What keeps it interesting and exciting and makes you stay with it?
Well, I think the one thing I've always said to myself, that when practices weren't fun, I guess at the time I'd look someplace else, but I really do still enjoy the practices. I enjoy the players, and I think the bondage that you have and the friendship that you have and, you know, just the camaraderie that you have with the team and building something from the first day, seeing it through to the playoff time is very exciting. It's still exciting to me.
We've got one regular season game left and then the playoffs begin. What are the outlooks for Husson when playoff time rolls around?
Well, we're just about there. We have our last game tomorrow night, and then the playoffs start next week. So they'll be busily seeding everyone on Sunday. And I would think we'd go in probably third spot at the present time, and they'll be seeded 1-8 for the New England Championship, and the first four teams get home court advantage, and so it looks like we probably will get that, and we'll play at home next Thursday. And the 1st and 2nd of March, the four teams that survive go to Portland, and they'll play off for the right to go to Nationals again.
Now, you've been nationally ranked in the NAIA standings all season long. Has that added any pressure to the club? Has it made it a little bit difficult for the kids playing under that kind of spotlight?
Well, I think our tradition has done that just at Huston itself. I think a lot of times there's some ghosts, you know, lurking around us. I think every time we go away, people are really looking forward to play us, which is great. You know, that makes it really fun basketball, and we know we have to play well every night because we're going to go into somebody's gym, and they're going to be certainly ready for us.
Now, with the NAIA dividing into the two divisions, that's really made things a lot more competitive nationwide, especially when that postseason play rolls around.
Well, that's true. Last year they started Division I and Division II, and we're a Division II school now. And last year we went to the new Nationals, to speak, and we went to Texas, and we found ourselves getting as far as the final 16, which was great. This year it's going to be moving again, going to Boise, Idaho. And I think the division has really helped New England. I think we can be much more competitive now in the national level.
Well, you've been a regular here at the high school tournaments over the years, and a lot of your great players throughout your time at Huston have come from this Eastern Maine and also the Western Maine tournament. You've had a pretty good Rockland connection in the last couple of years, too.
Absolutely. We have two players right now from Rockland that are playing very well for us, both of them averaging double figures, Richie Masaryk and Dwayne Knowlton. So we've had a lot of very good Maine players. Of course, we have Raymond Alley, who is on pace to maybe set the all-time scoring record in the state of Maine for college players. So we've had some wonderful Maine people, and that's why we're here at tournaments looking for more.
Well, Coach, you've done a great job over the years, and not only an outstanding coach, but one of the truly classy people in sports in Eastern Maine. Congratulations on the 500th win. Good luck in the playoffs.
Thank you very much, Rich.
Bruce McGregor, head coach of the Huston Braves. We're halftime of the Eastern Maine Class B Finals. Let's head back now to Bob and Joe.
Thank you, Rich. Let's look at the halftime statistics here. First for Rockland in the scoring, Jim York had 3 points. Mike Norton had one. Mark Fishman had two. Chris Seavey had two. And Brian Bartlett off the bench had 3 points for their total of 11 in the first half. And on the John Bapp side, Mark Baxter had two. Peter Murray had five. And Kenny Rassi, 11 big points for their 18 points. For the John Bapps Crusaders, and they lead 18-11 over the Tigers here in the first half. Here's your shooting. 4-for-11 for Rockland, 36%. 8-for-13 for Bapps, 61%. 2-for-3 from the line for Rockland, 66%. The same for John Bapps at 66%. Rockland's turnovers 6, Bapps' turnovers 4. The difference being, I think, their inability to get the ball to the basket and take it to the goal, the Rockland Tigers.
So the second half action momentarily away, and of course the championship game of the winner will be played down to Augusta next week, next Saturday. So this game tonight will help us for tomorrow night.
Of course it will.
Limestone versus Washington Academy. We're going to be active.
Right, we'll be very active, and this is a good game. It's a very tactical game by both coaches. Rockland wants to cut down on the turnovers, I'm sure, in the second half. John Bapps wants to play a solid game. Chris Elkington, I think, felt that he saw a little bit of dent in the John Bapps armor with Baxter and Dorian LeBlanc giving up those 15-foot shots, trying to get the ball inside, and we'll see if he stays with a 1-3-1 zone and does the same thing in the second half. It appears that he's going to, as John Bapps will put the ball into play for the second half of action.
So starting fives at the start of the game, start the second half. LeBlanc comes to the foul line, loops it into Webster. We just spoke about that. The shot is up, is no good. And Norton comes off the rebound. Norton playing with 3 fouls. So he is going to be very careful here in this period. 18-11, they always talk about the first 3 minutes of the third quarter. So we'll see what Rockland can muster here. Fishman with it, now back outside to York. York back to Fishman. Rockland in their orange. Now to Curtis. Curtis turns back to Catiline. Over to Fishman. Fishman looks inside. John Babson, a man-to-man. Rassi on Curtis. York at the foul line. Now to Fishman to the right side, Curtis. Curtis in the middle of Catiline. Catiline out the top to York. York fakes behind the back now. To the left side goes to Curtis. Curtis fakes the inside pass, goes back outside to Jamie York, now to Catiline. They're playing Catiline very loose, but that's a mile and a half three-pointer if he tries to take it. Norton back to Catiline, got it by Murray. 6:48 remains in third quarter action, or I should say 6:44 left in this quarter. With non-action. Oh! Dorian LeBlanc took Mr. Norton right back with him.
Well, he liked that. I'm sure Chris Elton didn't like that play because they ran some time down. And they're going to go to the foul line on a foul by Dorian LeBlanc, his second foul. Bob Zimbalek, he's over there. He can't believe it. What are they doing, he's saying. He's got his threw his hands up. Mike Norton on the line.
Can lightning strike twice? And they got to make those.
Going to catch up with them if they do not make those foul shots, especially in this type of a game.
18 to 11 the score. Norton's second shot, that's no good as well. But Fishman comes off with a rebound. He gets back outside. Through the legs, behind the back. York way outside. Coming out to challenge him is Webster. Now Catiline. As York works the ball to right to Fishman. 6-19 goes to Curtis. Curtis to Catiline. Now left side to Fishman.
Fishman was looking to take Baxter one-on-one there. They cleared out for him, but he did not take advantage of it.
Catiline to Curtis. Now it goes to Norton. Norton turns to Fishman. Number 41 with Baxter. Now he's going to go. There he goes. Nice move. You call it.
All right, got a nice pick at the top of the key and left Baxter at the pick and went in for the layup.
So I think we're going to see Mr. Baxter being worked on. LeBlanc now goes to Baxter. Now LeBlanc at the foul line to Baxter. Right side goes to Webster. Baxter's going to take an outside two and he makes it.
Right, and at the end of the second period, he was given that shot up, but Coach Zimbalek says, hey, you've got to be a threat from that position if we're going to open up the inside again.
20-13 the score now. John Babs leading by 7 in the third quarter. No, we're not in the first quarter. We're in the third quarter. Bartlett will check back in. The left side goes to Catiline of Rockland. Now to Norton. The blank's on him. Now it goes to Fishman. Baxter's guarding him. So we'll see if he tries to take a pick again and go with it. Trailing by 7, 5:02 left. Seavey will also check in when there's a time. Now it goes to Norton. Norton back to Fishman to the right side of Catiline. Catiline wants a Curtis at the foul line. He comes out. Now it goes to York. York's going to move. He turns back outside to Fishman. Now York will take it outside with 4:38 left. Chris Elkington likes this. He just applauded when York came out with the ball. Now to Norton. Norton turns. Now to York, back to Norton. Norton turns, Norton in the crowd. Fishman's going to take the pop. Yes.
Again
is right.
Work the ball, get in good position, and you got to make those shots.
Now we got a 5-point ball game. LeBlanc with it. Now to Baxter. Baxter inside to Rassi. Goodbye. No, he misses, gets his own rebound, puts it up and in.
See, that time there, LeBlanc was wide open. Fishman generally would be down fronting Rassi, but he cheated up to LeBlanc, and LeBlanc tossed it into Rassi, and Rassi made the second one.
So now we see the switch as Webster will go over after Fishman, but they're in a zone.
Now they went to zone, yes.
Catiline, see they recognize that, and Chris Elkending does. If they don't, he wants a timeout.
Right, he's going to say, hey, they've gone to a zone on us, so this is what we want to do against the zone. I'm sure he thought that maybe Bob Zimbalek would come out with a man-to-man here to start the second half of play. He did. They've solved that mystery and that puzzle. And now Chris Elkington calls a timeout so they can look at his zone offense against John Babs. In the timeout situation, Rockland has 2 left, John Babs 4 left.
As both teams talking over the coach, 22-15 the score. Once the ball gets inside to Rassi, it becomes very difficult for anyone to defend unless you're 6'10".
Well, he's got good size, and he's really developed his touch around the basket over the past year, and he's really a force to be reckoned with because he has that nice touch. Keeps the ball up there nice and high, able to lay it over the rim.
3:41 in third quarter action. Oh, let's see, it's 9:30. Seavey will inbound it and will go to Jimmy York. And Jamie's now going to hold the ball.
Going to hold it until they come out and play man-to-man or zone.
Webster, they come out for the double team, loops it to Seavey, back to York. Now cross it to
Fishman. Fishman works the ball. Now back it goes to York in the middle to Bartlett. Baseline to Norton. Back outside to York. Back to Fishman. Fishman starts to move. Now he goes down. The stop of the ball. Looks, loops it out to York. York retrieves it. A blank went after it, but couldn't get it.
Got a piece of York.
2:57 left. In the middle it goes to Bartlett. Got to be awake now because you may get the ball right after Kissel. There's Rockland Tigers working the ball around. 2:48 left. 22-15 the score. Now to Seavey. I thought the sophomore was going to let one fly. Norton. Norton gets by. Nice pass goes inside to Seavey. Misses the shot. And LeBlanc comes off the rebound. So good penetration that time.
Excellent penetration. You work so hard to get the shot. You just got to make them. Now Baps.
Baps slowing the ball down.
Giving them a little taste of their own medicine here. No way. Let's see what Chris Elkington does. Chris over there waiting.
Well, you know what Chris did against McDormick. So at the end of three complete,
he's got his legs crossed. He's over there.
Now Simlich says there's that to move.
There he goes.
Long pass to Webster in the corner. Now to Baxter. Back to Webster. Webster looking inside. Double team and Fishman. He goes for the ball. He's coming up with it. He's turning.
Arrows going to Rockland.
Mr. Thurston, get right down there. The only thing is, Mike, don't put the whistle in your mouth when you're on the floor.
Right.
You could be swallowing it.
Coming back, John Baps again setting up in their half-court defense.
York moves to the left side to Norton. Norton now cross-courts it to Bartlett. 1:42 left. Goes outside to Jamie York. Off to Fishman. Fishman starts to work to the right side. Bounces to Seavey. Seavey inside to Bartlett. Bartlett turns. Now he goes out to Fishman. Loops it inside to Norton. There it is. Bang!
I was just going to suggest maybe Norton and Fishman changing places because Fishman, Norton has been open for the baseline jumper, but that was a great pass by Fishman for the Norton layup.
Webster. Now it goes to Baxter. Baxter to LeBlanc. LeBlanc back to Baxter. Now inside it goes to Rassi, and they're going to call a jump ball. And Norton just threw him. That'll be John Bass' ball as Lauchs will come back in the game.
York's doing a little bit of officiating, saying over the back, over the back.
Catiline will check in as well for Rockland. Well, 22-17. There's Rassi will put the ball in play. Goes to LeBlanc. And what are they going to call here? Catiline?
Catiline holding Rassi as he was coming across the lane.
That's a good foul because there's going to be a lot of them. Different people are going to be on Rassi. And he's had that all year, so there's nothing new to him. Baxter, now to Rassi. Rassi turns, nice touch, no good. Rebound tipped up and in. I think a Rockland player got that one.
Yeah, I think they may give it to Peter Murray, but
the closest two. And a 24-17 score. Fishman again to Norton. Norton now to Catiline. Catiline turns back outside to Fishman. Lauchs out there with him, with John Baps. Now to Bartlett. Bartlett turns, looks in the corner, goes to Seavey. Seavey pathway into the foul line. Outside to Fishman. 24-17 the score. Norton. Now it goes to Catiline. Catiline baseline now right side. Goes back outside the foul line extended Bartlett. Way outside with 15 seconds left.
One shot, they're going to take one. Down to 10.
24-17. Fishman now. Fishman. Well, a three would be nice. Fishman's going to go with it. Fishman puts it up. It's no good. Rebound is out of bounds.
Foul on Baxter. I believe there's a foul on Baxter on the rebounding action.
But that'll only be a ball put in play as Baker will come back in.
Oh, unless he's going to give him a shot. He may have been on his way up on the rebound. Baxter knocked it out of his hands, and then Baxter going to the bench.
Our replay will tell us. We were boxed out by the trees down there. 2 seconds.
Here it is. There's the shot. There's the pass. Yes, and he was shooting the ball.
Aren't you an eagle eye? Seavey now with two important foul shots. It would be nice to have these. Foul shot is up, and yes, there's one. 24-19 or 18.
6 points different.
22, number 22 defense. Called out by Chris Elkington.
2 seconds remaining now, 24-19 if he can make this one. And no, he doesn't get it. And Curtis is in there, and a shot is put up, but the land of the Giants by Baker, and that was no good. 24-18, John Babs leads. We'll be back with fourth quarter action right after this.
You're watching Freeman Basketball on Maine Public Television.
Nice piece of coaching in that period by Chris Elkington. Got it down to 6 points. There's seven at the half, 24-18. With 8 minutes left here, Rockland's got the ball. So he's got to feel good about what's happened so far.
Now he's got 8 minutes to try to untrack and get ahead. And this would be a gigantic upset if Rockland could get it. And now we're into a waiting game.
Stand and hold, and Bob Simlick, oh, Bob Simlick is saying now, stay back.
All right, because they'll win, right? 24-18. 7:42 left in this contest. Catiline will hold it.
Chris Elkington talking to his staff over there. Just looked at his watch, looks up at the clock. There he is.
So a pillow, a book, and a deflated ball. He didn't say what kind of magazine, though, did he? Sports Illustrated, ahead of it.
So, with the rule, the lack of action rule being taken off the books, Rockland has every opportunity to stand and hold the ball as long as they so wish. Got to remember, they now there's a clock, good picture of the clock. Got to remember that now he's coaching from the bench.
Remember that they're still behind by 6 points.
That's the only problem they have at this point.
All right, he just said go.
I think you're either going to get a 45-second clock in this game, or you're going to take that rule back. Backs goes to the steal, can't get it. Catiline with it now. 6:37 left in this contest for the Class B championship. Now it goes to Catiline, back to York.
John Babs in their own standard 1-3-1 zone.
Fishman in the corner, Catiline at the top. York, Norton. Norton turns, now the foul line goes to Seavey. Now to Catiline. Back to Seavey. To York. 6:04 remains in this contest. 24-18. Yes, you heard it right. 24-18. Fishman. Oh! Nice pass to Seavey, too. He would have had the layup.
Excellent play that time. Set up by Fishman, and Seavey just unable to control the ball.
Now I think Bob Simlick just yelled out to hold the ball.
Well, they're getting into their spread offense.
No, spread holding the ball.
Spread offense. Dorian LeBlanc with the ball over to Baxter.
.538 remains. As you can see, Dorian LeBlanc.
Now Rockland people are very uneasy behind us, and John Babs people cheering on the other side. Just the reverse is happening.
Chris Elkington is telling the people who they should guard.
Come
now
on,
he's going to come out and get him. Now goes to Murray inside. Murray looking around. Now to LeBlanc. LeBlanc trying to get it inside. And there's going to be a foul. Is this on Norton? If it is, that's four.
Real aggressive after the ball that time. Mike Norton. He went after the man rather than the ball. Here it is right here. Watch him. Reaches up high and picks off Rassie.
Well, we're not going to get into the one and one because we're a mile away from it right now with 5:06 left. Grassy outside. 24-18 the score. And both teams can hold the ball, as we have seen. Fishman comes down to talk to Elkington as John Bass will put in play right in front of our camera on the monitor. And the bounce pass goes to Lout, now to Rassie. Rassie turns back to Lout. 4:53 left. Goes outside to LeBlanc. LeBlanc with Fishman on him. Now to Rassie. Bartlett is on him.
Don Bash leading 24-18. In the corner, it goes to LeBlanc. Back outside to Baxter. Now to LeBlanc. Goes to Grassi. Now to LeBlanc. I mean to Baxter. Oh-hum.
Into their offense, their man-to-man offense. First time they've run this evening.
We got to show some discipline, too. Grassi turns. Ballard finally fouls him.
Fourth team foul now on Rockland. Still no shooting. Here it is. There's a double team. York and Bartlett. Bartlett going up for the ball and over the arms of Rassi.
Webster will check back in for John Babs and Laux leaves.
I was wondering when Bob was going to put Webster back in.
Baxter loops it over to LeBlanc. And LeBlanc's fouled by Fishman. So that's what they don't want to do, because once you get him on the line, you can kiss it goodbye.
Well, they got one more to waste after this one, and then John Babs goes to the line.
Baxter will put in play in front of the scorer's table. To Murray, the ball is deflected away. Nice try by Seavey, and that's the one they wasted. And now the next one will put him in deep jeopardy, as the John Babs Crusaders have a very fine shooting, foul shooting team. Baxter will put it in play. It goes to Webster. Got it by Seavey. Now it goes to Rassi. Grassi with the ball, the baseline, underneath to LeBlanc, and the ball's ripped away by York. Great steal by Jamie. 4 minutes remains in this contest. They've got to get something here. If he's got to hold it now, there's not enough time. So I looked over to Elkin to see what to do. York with the ball.
Big 1-3-1 zone by Babb still, just to keep Rockland at bay.
If they do score, he says to call a timeout. 3:39 left. A three would be nice right about now. Goes to Bartlett. Bartlett skips it across to Fishman. Fishman starts in the middle now, and they're going to call a foul on Webster, but that'll only be the fourth team foul.
Bob Zimmerman can't stand fouls. He just can't stand them. He's up and screaming over there. Come on, Jason.
Seavey, and they're going to
technical foul.
Technical foul, oh. Reaching over.
Right.
Well, this will be good, because evidently he reached over while he's trying to take the ball out. If it's a, is it a technical? No, I thought that you'd get the shot out of that.
No,
evidently not. It's on Webster, though. That's his third. Nice move inside and up around and in by Fishman. Oh, what a shot.
Dipsy do, timeout, and they missed it.
Yeah, they did. The officials did. The Rockland kids didn't. LeBlanc now. Goes to Webster, goes to the corner of Baxter, now to Rassi. Rassi's gonna put it in.
Nice movement, good ball movement by John Babs that time. Down to the wing, into the big guy, turns and lays it in.
26-20 to score. 3 minutes remain in this contest. Ball's deflected, stolen by Murray. Re-stolen, but York is fouling.
Peter Murray on the steal, got a hand in the passing lane. And we're going to the one and one to John Babs. Great defensive play by Peter Murray of the Crusaders in that big wide zone, wide body zone that John Babs employs in the half court. And there's Peter, good shot of him. Number 50, 6'8" senior, Peter Murray on the line for one and one.
So Chris Elvington had called it. He said that the maker, should you make the shot, call the time. Foul shot is up and good. This is where it becomes very crucial, because you can't put Babs on the line.
Very excellent foul shooting team.
As a friend of mine down in Blue Hill would say, it's America's team.
America's team, huh?
Simblick wants to talk it over now.
But he wants to set up the defense again to stifle Rockland. And now we have Rockland with two timeouts and John Babs with three timeouts. Possession arrow going to Babs, and they're on the line for the second half of the one-on-one for Peter Murray.
27-20 to score.
The other thing that Babs does with this big wide zone at this point in the game, the way the game has unfolded, it takes a lot of time for Rockland to get a good shot. And now the clock is the ally of Babs, because the Rockland's behind by seven. So they'll probably have to up the tempo a little bit and do a little bit less passing and maybe a little bit more dribbling to get through the zone and take a few more outside shots.
John Babs, 20 wins, no losses on the season. This has been one of the finer Babs teams that Coach Slimlick has had. Of course, when you have all that height, but they're talented, too.
No, they are talented. They're well-schooled, well-drilled. They pass the ball to each other. They play good defense. They've changed up their defenses tonight. A lot more variety Bob Simulek has used this year than he has in the past years.
And he's had a chance to do that. So Peter Murray now will try to cap a pair as his team leads by 7 points, 27-20, here in the fourth period. Yes, it is the fourth period. So it's 28-20 now with 2:53 left.
Back in their zone, 1-3-1.
So let their rain threes. Seavey with it now.
Look how wide he's created that zone. Look how wide it is with Murray up on top.
Seavey now to York. York to the right side. York looking and goes to Fishman. 2:35 left. York, Jamie takes a three. It's no good. Rebound inside is fought for. Seavey comes off with it with the help of Norton. And he goes back outside to Fishman. Back to York. Jamie Patway in, turns, looking now, goes to Fishman. Nice scoop pass inside of Ballard, and he misses the shot but draws the foul.
Good pass by
Great
Fishman.
Look that time.
Excellent call, Joe. He really looked down low, looked away, and found Bartlett on the baseline. And Brian Bartlett's going to go to the line for two shots.
So Brian Bartlett, one of the super subs that the Rockland Tigers have developed this year. Chance now to try to cut the lead. The foul shot is up, and he gets the bounce.
Set the roll.
Up and down.
At the big high bounce.
There's the Rockland bench. Second shot up, a high arcing shot. Net this time.
That's better. Now here's the press right here.
Two threes will tie it. Pass goes to Rassi. And right there was Bartlett with him. And Fishman's going to be fouling LeBlanc, and he'll go to the foul line.
Mark Fishman going for the steal in the backcourt, stops the clock. 2:12 left with a 6-point lead. John Babs during the blank going to the line.
When Babs started this season, they did not have a point guard. And Bob Simulek had a search for one. But this young man has stepped forward, has done just what he's asked, and has played very, very well. And matter of fact, has played well in this tournament. He's put together three pretty good games. Foul shot is good, and that's what I mean.
Really solid tournament. And the other factor that's against Rockland now, John Babs has only committed 14 fouls.
That's it. LeBlanc's second shot as he gets ready for it, puts it up, and Dorian hits a pair. So you go down one side, and you hit two, and they come back and get two on you. 8-point lead with 2:09 left in this contest. Maine Public Television bringing you this game. Hope you're enjoying it as much as we are bringing it to you. There is a shot by Palmer, and he hits. Baseline shot, 30-24, down to two trays now. Nice steal inside Seavey, and they're going to call a foul on Baxter, but it's a wasted foul.
It's a good shot. That is an excellent foul. Oh,
I know, but I mean wasted as far as the 1-1.
Right, exactly. But
saved the layup.
Saves the layup, and it's only got five team fouls now, so good play by Baxter.
30-24 the score. Left there rain threes. Nice move by Fishman. Goes to Norton. Norton now to Bartlett. Bartlett will go back out with it to York. York to the right side. He can ring the threes. Now to Seavey. Swings it over to Norton. Norton partway in now. They've got to up-tempo it now because there's 1:30 left. And inside it goes to Fishman. Puts it up off the glass. No good. There's Bartlett. He puts it back up. Oh, the shot. This will be a two-shot foul.
Two-shot foul. So. Going to the glass high, the Rockland Tigers, to try to claw their way back into this thing. Down six with Bartlett. There it is right there. Nice rebound by Bartlett, and there's a foul by Murray on the arm. No chance for him to put that in.
Murray commits his second personal foul. 16 fouls, but this is a shooting foul. And the last time on the line, Bartlett sunk two. The foul shot's up, and that's three in a row.
He was going to get another one anyway because Webster went in the lane. It's Chris. He likes what he sees. Might be a little bit too late.
I don't know. 1:24. So we'll see if he can make this one. Foul shot is up and good. He wins two. 30-26. Now we're down to a tray and a single. LeBlanc. LeBlanc throws it way down over Baxter's head, but Murray was there. 1-1. Remember, if Rockland. Rockland fouls, now to Baxter, back outside to Webster. And the try for the backdoor steal, couldn't get it. Murray with it, and Catiline, good foul, you had to do it, you had to stop the clock.
Only ran about 20 seconds off the clock, so Webster going to the line.
30-25 to score. 1 minute remains in this contest.
Now the pressure situation, shooting the foul shots under the pressure.
That's it. But they've probably done it before. This will be a one-on-one. The foul shot is up. It's no good. Taken off by York. 30-26. Chris says go for it. York with it now. Catiline. They can't afford a travel violation or a three-second violation without a shot. Fishman back to York. York fakes now. Starts to go with it. Turns. Fishman's going to have to take it. He does. Puts it up and in. And they want timeout. They want timeout. They get it. They get the timeout. 35 seconds left. And Rockland has cut this game down to two. I told you. You didn't believe me, did you?
30-28. A great offensive display that time by Rockland. Great patience to pass the ball around. Almost got a travel on York. Here's the shot. Here comes Fishman up and nothing but net. Bang, 30-28. There's Chris Elkington. Timeout situations. Rockland with one, John Babs with three. Possession arrow to John Babs. But we're going to see some pressure. We'll see if they foul early again and just take the chance. But now a two-point lead, that puts a little different situation on the fouls. They've got to be careful, go for some steals, and then maybe run the let the clock come down a little bit and then foul. But out they come. Rockland on their toes, sprint to the court. Catiline, York, Bartlett, and Fishman.
Goes into Rassi, 33 seconds left. LeBlanc in the backcourt. Fishman goes for the steal, down with it, LeBlanc. LeBlanc goes to Webster inside, the ball's knocked away, saved by Jamie, but it comes off to Rassi. They're gonna gang up on him, and there's gonna be a foul on Catiline. A good foul with 19 seconds left.
And they got a nice bounce that time because York went out of bounds to receive the ball, threw it back in, and it went under Murray's legs to Rassi. Under Murray's legs, he couldn't get down. Here comes Rassi, picks it up. He's going to the line.
Well, we'll see if he can make a foul shot. If he can't, Rockland rebounds. They've got a chance to win this thing. Foul shot by Rassi's up. No good! Rebound taken off by Fishman. Fishman starts down in front of the bench now. Comes off to Butler. Now it goes off to Jamie York. And 11 seconds left, and they want timeout. Mercy. That's his last timeout.
John Babs has three. The possession arrow is still with Babs, but here Rockland has got a chance to tie a win in regulation. 10 seconds left up on the clock. 10 ticks. The ball will be out of bounds in front of the Rockland bench, which gives them a pretty good opportunity to spread the floor out, take a look and see where they can get the ball. I would imagine that Fishman's going to have it when there's about 2 or 3 seconds left.
Well, it was 1 minute left. There's the play right there.
Here it is, right here. Watch, right between Murray's legs, and here comes Rassi. He gets the ball, and the foul is on Catiline. He goes and misses. Fishman gets the rebound, and down they go to call a timeout. So the stage is set. Let's see if John Babs plays his own, which hasn't been very successful for him in the last 3 or 4 times down, or if they go man-to-man. They got all their starters in, Webster, Baxter, LeBlanc, Rassi, and Murray. Yeah, they're going man-to-man.
10 seconds remains now. Chance to win or a chance to tie. York, right down the middle. Now it goes off to Norton. 5 seconds, they gotta at least get the shot off, and that's a double dribble. That's a good call.
I thought so.
A good call. Double dribble on Norton. It looked like he did. He had it, and then Chris sees it too. Another timeout with 2 seconds left. So I guess just the pass in will do it now.
Right, and that was a timeout by Babs. So they've got two, and Rockland, none. John Babs gonna get the ball, foul line extended, and gotta go the length of the court. I don't know if we're gonna see the double dribble again. We might be able to bring that up for you, but here he is, here's Norton. He's out front, there's one dribble right there. Okay, now he pivots. And then he dribbles again.
Right.
So he
it was a good call. Mike Thurston made the call. Good call.
Excellent call. And Mike didn't hesitate. He was right on top of it. Poor Mike Norton. He started dribble to his right, picked it up,
went back to his left with another dribble for the double dribble call. Set up the situation. John Babs has got to go three quarters of the length of the court. You'll probably see Rockland foul before John Babs gets the ball in bounds. Take a foul before the clock starts and send Babs to the line. That's about the only thing they can do right now because there's only 2 seconds.
So they put man up. Baxter loops it to Rassi. Rassi has it. There's going to be a foul.
Out of bounds. Out of bounds. It's going to be Rockland's ball.
1 second.
You've got no timeouts. He's saying no timeouts.
Yep. So now I guess the questioning about the clock, would they be 1 second or two? But the ball did get in bounds,
yes,
so it
did
eat the 1 second.
Exactly right. It touched Rassi.
Well, listen, this is going to help Rockland
because
Babs calls timeout.
Right. It touched Rassi on the inbounds pass. They started the clock. The whistle blew with the contact, and Mike Thurston called him out of bounds. So there was 1 second left. There's now 1 second left on the clock. Rockland has the ball at midcourt.
This is going to be easy. Right here.
Here it is.
So there's 2 seconds left right now.
Right.
There's the
whistle's blown.
Right.
And
so I got the 1 second.
1 second left.
Jamie York with a three-pointer.
And
it is over.
Right. I think what you might see, though, in this situation, if we can set it up, one timeout for John Babs. Possession arrow going to Babs. Rockland, no timeouts. But they've got to take John Babs down in the paint and then bring a player towards him, because they really don't have time to do anything else. So the ball has got to come in somewhere on the wing or at the top, turn around and let it fly at the buzzer.
For a three, Jimmy York. I've already called it, I've choreographed it.
He's on the court, see he's down low.
Yep.
Okay, he's down low. They're gonna give a screen to somebody.
There it is.
Fishman, there's
Jimmy,
York.
Jimmy York, no. All right, but he had the chance to shoot anyway. So John Babs wins it, they struggle, but they win it. America's team.
Norman Laux down here doing a roll on the floor for the John Babs Crusaders. There he is.
And no one's paying attention to him.
Oh.
Maybe he's throwing a fit, I don't know.
There's Bob Cymbalek and Chris Elkington at half court giving each other a big hug. A great game, a well-coached game by Chris Elkington. He called it at the beginning of the game. He said, I got to do one of two things, and he did the thing that he had to do to get his team in a position to win, and they almost pulled it out, 30-28.
They're right in the center of the court, still talking, and I think people around will be talking about this for a long time, one of the lowest scored 30-28 game that we've seen in quite a while.
And they're just talking about the timeout over there, because what Sims saw was York go to the official and call for a timeout. Official didn't recognize it. And, of course, Rockland had no more timeouts, so Sim was saying, Rockland called the timeout so he'd get the technical foul and the ball down the other end, but it didn't happen. Mark Baxter, number 32, for the Crusaders, up on the ring, getting the net.
Good now. Good. Nice seal.
There's Sim right there, 30-28 winner. Redemption time?
I think so.
Redemption time.
Well, boy, they struggled. They did struggle. It was the outcome of this game was not known until Jamie York. I think if they hadn't have been out there, York might have got the three off in plenty of time. Yeah. But I think the clock had run at that time.
There was the traditional handshake going on now.
But look what Chris Elkington has done this year. And I think you people down in Rockland and the Knox County area will be very pleased, win or lose, that he had one starter from a year ago, Mark Fishman. He's developed his three-man bench like he had a year ago, and he's back in the finals, and he's been in the finals for all the 5 years, and that's very commendable.
Well, it's a testimony not only to his coaching, but also his program. He has a great program down there in Rockland, and the kids really responded this year, and I think that's a lot to do with tradition. You got a guy like Fishman coming back, and a kid like Norton, who played a little bit last year, coming back. And now let's go to the public address system. There they are.
This Eastern Maine tournament. Your winning season, respect for each other, and quality of play have provided great entertainment for your spectators. Your schools and communities have every reason to be proud. If I could have representatives from Eastern Maine committee member Ron Gleason from Belfast Area High School and John Perry from Herman High School to assist in the presentation of the awards. First, the coaches from Rockland, District High School, if you'd come forward, please. Christian Elkington, Assistant Larry Terrio.